want to know how these seats feel.
The first phase of public outreach in BART's effort to replace its oldest in the nation train car fleet is nearing the finish line.
So far, a smashing success, because what we're really garnishing is the opinions of the constituents who are going to be the people that end up riding the next fleet of trains.
We're very customer oriented, and we really want our riders and our customers to feel that it's their train, and it can't be their train unless they have some good input into it.
BART is hosting these seat labs to gather public input on the project to replace its entire fleet of train cars, the oldest in the nation, with the fleet of the future. As the name implies, the seat labs give the public a chance to express their opinions on seat options.
I would take cleanliness over a comfortable padded seat, but a little padded doesn't hurt.
I think one thing about hard seats is that it suits everyone. A soft seat can really mess with someone's back, but a hard seat will be okay with someone with back problems and without.
I chose to keep it the same material that it had, maybe more, a little more cushiony.
Well, personally, I like this one.
And that's a polyester, and this is the existing fabric, which is a wool nylon.
But the fleet of the future is more than just about the seat of the future. We're getting input on other design factors, too.
BART has a real bad problem with screeching noise through the tunnels and on the curves. It's so bad that at least once a day I actually physically have to block my ears.
So they should be strapped for people who are around 5'2" or thereabouts.
I do know that the signage could probably be updated.
With many of the train cars almost 40 years old and nearing the end of their serviceable life, replacing BART's oldest in the nation trains is a high priority for BART board members who want to make sure the job is done right.
A great deal of thought is being given to the design, global design of the train itself, as far as quietness, as far as fire safety is concerned, as far as communication with announcements to the public.
We will have signs that tell you where you've been, where you are, and where you're going.
That's pretty helpful, because a lot of times you can't hear the conductor announcing the stops. It's pretty hard to hear.
More than 1,000 surveys have been completed by people attending seat labs like these, some with very specific feedback.
We have had two people who are visually impaired that came in and identified that the seats were too low. For a visually impaired person that has a dog who's going to be sitting underneath the seat directly under their feet, that's crucial. That's going to make a difference.
The feedback will be shared with industrial designers, who will use it to come up with 3 renderings that incorporate the most requested features and try to balance trade-offs for the best possible interior design. Then, later this summer, there will be another round of public input on those 3 models. The first new cars of the fleet of the future could be in service by 2017. To learn more and give us your thoughts, visit bart.gov/cars. Lisa Bernard, BART TV News.